Hi, I'm Sarah. Now that we have shown the process of mitosis using the beads, we will explore the process of meiosis. Before we begin, remember that meiosis produces gametes, or sex cells. Gametes are haploid, or N, because they have only one of each chromosome pair. The union of two haploid gametes and fertilization produces a unique zygote, or fertilized egg, with the diploid number restored. To end up with haploid cells, the initial cells must go through interphase, as we saw in mitosis. But in meiosis, there are two divisions instead of one, and the first division is very different from what we saw in mitosis. Notice in the graphic that cells are already haploid after the first division. In mitosis, there were never any haploid cells, before, after, or during the process. Then the second division in meiosis produces cells that have single chromosomes. That is to say, the chromatids have been pulled apart and are now in separate cells as new single chromosomes. Meiosis starts with a 2N equals 4 cell, just like mitosis. That is, the cell has two homologous pairs for a chromosome number of 4. At the beginning of meiosis, the homologous chromosomes come together and exchange equal parts. This is called crossing over, and only occurs in meiosis. It is easy to show this with the beads, as red beads are exchanged for yellow beads. Remember that the red beads are from the female parent, and the yellow beads are from the male parent. When the homologs come together, we have four sets of the beads next to each other. You already know what sister chromatids are, and at the start of meiosis, they are identical to each other. Recall that homologous chromosomes have the same genes, but may have different versions of those genes, or alleles. So non-sister chromatids can have different versions of the same gene. The act of crossing over will result in new combinations of genetic material that did not exist before in nature. In this example, one of the chromosomes has alleles for sickle cell hemoglobin, attached earlobes, and blood type A. The other chromosome has alleles for normal hemoglobin, free earlobes, and blood type O. So the non-sister chromosomes have different alleles, and after crossing over occurs, we can have a unique combination of alleles for these traits on one chromosome. In the bead model, we can see the new set of alleles as a chromosome with red and yellow beads. This means that the organism has recombined the alleles it received from its parents into a new set. In the first division of meiosis, the homologs will separate. So the spindle fibers will attach to the double magnet, which represents the centromere of a replicated chromosome, and the sister chromatids will stay intact. This metaphase, called metaphase one, looks very different from what we saw in mitosis. The homologs are separated by the spindle fibers, but the chromatids are still intact. At the end of the first division, the cells are haploid, because homologs are now in separate cells. They are no longer in pairs. However, the chromosomes are still replicated, so we refer to this as N times two. In the second division, metaphase 2 happens in unison in both haploid cells. Now the separation of the chromatids happens the same way as it did in mitosis, except each cell has only one of each chromosome, instead of two. Now the spindle fibers pull the chromatids apart. Finally, each haploid gamete has one of each chromosome, for a total of two chromosomes in each cell. Each cell is unique because of crossing over that occurred in prophase 1. Here you can see the final products of meiosis. So to summarize, the first division of meiosis separates homologs. 2N, that is, diploid cells, become N, or haploid cells. The second division separates chromatids. Cells that were designated as times 2 now have single chromosomes. So we've reviewed the process for both mitosis and meiosis, and now you're ready for the lab activity. See you in the lab!